So in the United States every year, there are about 17 million biofilm infections. These are life-threatening bacterial infections that we can't treat. So biofilms are surface-attached bacterial communities that are essentially full of metabolically dormant bacterial cells that exhibit high levels of antibiotic tolerance. There are over 500,000 deaths that are chalked up to bacterial biofilm infections. Bacteria actually exist in two different lifestyles. These planktonic cells, or these free swimming, free floating bacteria, are what we've typically thought about when we think about bacteria, okay? And then what we've learned is that they actually prefer to live on surfaces, and they form these biofilms where they're encased in this matrix of biomolecules that serves to protect them. And so once they're housed in these biofilms, they're metabolically dormant, and so conventional antibiotics that we've discovered as bacterial growth inhibitors are automatically ineffective against these dormant, persistent bacterial biofilms. We've discovered these new compounds, we're developing them now, and so in our lab and in our extended research team through collaboration, we found that our compounds are highly potent against not only the planktonic bacteria, also the persistent biofilm state, okay? In addition, they're not lysing red blood cells. So this is the main difference between our compounds and other biofilm eradicating agents that are developed. So our compounds, compound 14, is a halogenated phenazine. So this compound is very potent at killing planktonic cells. In addition, we're very potent at killing biofilm cells. And that's what these empty wells are corresponding to, are basically eradicated biofilms that are in these wells. The thing that people should be excited about, you know, so this discovery will allow us to finally get at bacterial biofilms in a way that conventional antibiotics or other potential therapeutic anti-biofilm compounds cannot do. And so, you know, we're still developing. There's still a lot of hurdles that we have to pass. But in terms of a positive first step, we've definitely been able to establish a highly potent active series of compounds that can be tuned. Okay, so there's a lot of opportunity for moving these things forward, moving these compounds forward. So we're hoping that these compounds can provide an avenue of biofilm eradication and therapeutic use in the future.